that the Real Estate Regulation and Development Bill 2016, as passed by the Rajya Sabha, be taken into consideration. Madam Speaker, I would like to request the honorable members to pay special attention to this bill, because this bill is the need of the hour. The requests have come from various quarters for all those years, and it's an issue which is pending for long. We have been discussing about some regulation in the real estate for the last 11 years, because the buyers, the consumers across the country, they're all agitated rightly, and they are not getting adequate redressal system as per the previous arrangement. So keeping that in mind, earlier during the UPA regime, a bill was brought and bill was referred to Standing Committee, and Standing Committee in its correct wisdom has made certain recommendations, and out of the 30 dot recommendations, 23 recommendations were accepted, and then after this government came in between, there is a change of government, and the government have brought that in the form of a new bill. After the bill has gone to Rajya Sabha, because it has originated from there, and Rajya Sabha in its wisdom has referred again this matter to the Select Committee. The bill which was approved by the Standing Committee consisting of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha was again referred to Select Committee of Rajya Sabha. I have agreed simply because I want the bill finally to be passed at the end of the day. So we have agreed, and the Select Committee of the other house has done an excellent job, and they made their own recommendations and then sent back to Rajya Sabha. And now that bill, Madam, I am very happy to share with the house, that bill was debated, discussed and decided in Rajya Sabha almost unanimously, with one party of course, ADMK. I must put it on record, they have raised a fundamental issue, saying that the parliament has no jurisdiction on this issue because it's a matter concerning the local bodies and the state. We discussed about that matter within ourselves, ma'am, in the department also, and I have referred the matter to law ministry, and law ministry has opined yes, the parliament has a jurisdiction. Then subsequently I have referred the matter to the Attorney General of India. The Attorney General of India also, after careful study, he has sent back saying the Parliament of India has the jurisdiction to pass such a legislation in the larger interest of the people. Keeping that in mind, the present bill has been brought in, and in the Rajya Sabha it was approved by all parties' support. I am very happy to state it. Madam, here the bill, the purpose of the bill is, the bill is going to make the consumer the king. The consumer the king, but bring in such needed regulation and transparency to the people who are involved in this sector. This bill seeks to create a set of rights and obligations for both the consumer as well as developer. Secondly, this bill seeks to encourage both them to live up to the expectations of each other as per the agreement entered into by both of them. When you purchase a house, you enter into an agreement. If one of the parties failed to perform the obligation, then the bill, the provisions of the bill will come into operation. If they mutually agreed upon, nobody is going to intervene. But unfortunately, what is happening, the buyers, the consumers are always at the receiving end. In India, the law of torts is very weak compared to other countries, Western countries and all, because we don't have such provisions to enforce the provisions of law. And you know, in India also, the issues take long time, and courts also, you have such a system wherein so much delay is being caused. I'm not here to accuse the judiciary, but the judicial system in India is such as are now today, we are not able to get speedy justice. So the helpless consumer should not be left to the lurch. That has really told me my conscience that we must bring this bill at the earliest. This bill seeks to establish regulatory authorities with which the developer will register the project to be launched. If X want to launch a project, he has to register it with the regulatory authority. Simple. Secondly, while doing so, they have to declare all project information, including the details of developers, status of land and various approvals, project schedule, information regarding architects, structural engineers, etc., so that there is transparency, people can get satisfied who are the architects, who are the developers, who are the engineers, what is the size of the project. All these things will be in public domain. And secondly, the disclosure helps home buyers make an informed choice. Kaun si makan kharid karna, iska developer kaun hai, iska architect kaun hai, pura vivara janta ke samne aayega, aur jo कंज्यूमर है, ग्राहक, उन लोगों को एक अच्छा चॉइस मिलेगा, इसको चूज करना, उसको चूज करना, किसको उनका पसंद है तो वो चूज करेंगे, पूरा जानकारी लोगों के सामने रखने से। अपार्ट फ्रॉम प्रमोटिंग फेयर प्ले इन रियल एस्टेट ट्रांसैक्शंस एंड एंश्योरिंग टाइमली एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, इज अनदर इश्यू। टाइमली एग्जीक्यूशन इज ए मेजर इश्यू। पीपल डू नॉट रेस्पेक्ट टाइम एंड देन विद द रिजल्ट द कॉस्ट एक्सपेक्टेशन गोस अप एंड द बायर द कंज्यूमर इज ऑलवेज पुट टू लॉस। Keeping that in mind, timely execution of the projects, the bill seeks to provide uniform regulatory environment and orderly growth of the real estate sector. We want the real estate sector to grow. As a Minister of Urban Development, I have no hesitation also. We feel that the real estate developers also are partners in development. We don't consider them untouchable. Some people have the habit of condemning private sector. We don't. We don't believe in government. We are all in government that private sector is bad. Private-public partnership is need of the hour. That is the way forward. We have seen the other methods all these years, and then we have learned by experience. That's why we have come to this conclusion. Display of unanimity, spirit of give and take by both the government and the opposition enabled this passage of the crucial bill in Rajya Sabha on 10th March. And the stage is now set for receiving the Lok Sabha approval. The manner in which it was passed in the upper house clearly highlights the highest legislature of the land could do further to the aspirations of the people. The spirit of camaraderie demonstrated in upper house underlined what we could do collectively for the betterment of the lives of the people. The Rajya Sabha witnessed the rare occasion of the opposition and treasury benches giving credit to each other for introducing and piloting this bill. I have no hesitation to say, I said it also there, I am saying it here also, it was the bill brought during the earlier regime by the earlier minister, and then certain improvements have been made in that bill by both the standing committee and the select committee. So finally now the time has come during this government that we brought this bill, and I am putting it before the house. The credit for the significant improvements on the bill goes to the work done by the standing committee, goes to the select committee. The ideas they have exchanged among themselves and the conclusions they have reached us, that has really helped me to come to some conclusions. Normally, you know, in many of the cases we come to Lok Sabha and people say, you have majority here, you just got it passed and all, but we have gone to Rajya Sabha because the issue was pending there, and I am happy that the Rajya Sabha, after deliberations,
and the same system has to be followed,
including Aadhaar.
Very good suggestion. If same system of consultation, discuss, debate, decide, do not disrupt, if it is allowed, I am very happy to take this route. What Premachandran ji said is really a good idea. People of the country, they want it. Today morning also I got a message about this, saying that please preserve the example of Rajya Sabha and follow it also. I have no problem at all. Government have nothing to hide. Either Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, both of them have been given their respective jurisdictions and responsibilities. We should work together. Both of us are called as Parliament of India. So if you don't perform our responsibilities, neither Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, then it will go to Paralok Sabha. This is what has happened to many of the bills earlier also. I don't want that to happen. If you discuss and debate and decide, good things will emerge. Good ideas will come. Nobody is perfect. In spite of our experience also, nobody is perfect. After discussion of some saner points, good points have emerged. The government had no hesitation at any time to take those suggestions and then take it forward. But at the same time, I will come to that point. I was moved by the response of the public on social media also after the Rajya Sabha created the bill. There was so much appreciation from across the country, from different parts of the country, hailing the passage of the bill in Rajya Sabha. Many of them posted that they rejoiced at that historic moment, and some were overwhelmed with emotions. I understand such reactions as a cries of joy after having gone through the pain of waiting for long to get their due. And finally, the moment of restoring order in the real estate sector becoming a reality. Madam, in this country, lots of consumers have been taken for a ride by unscrupulous elements. I am not trying to damn the entire real estate sector. There are great people, there are good people, there are reputed builders, architects also. We have constructed many buildings across the country. And our aim of housing for all by 2022 is not possible by mere central government or mere state government's efforts alone. Government of the India, government, state government, and then private sector also should join in a big way. If you consider the housing sector in the country, the contribution of the private sector, individuals, whatever you call, that is also immense. They have done a great job. and we have so many prestigious projects in the country. That's why even the FDI also is coming in the particular sector. Ma'am, the media has been following the progress for the last 3 years and has given their thumbs up to the bill also. Almost all the sections of the media, they have hailed the passage of the bill because it enhances the confidence of the consumers and investors, ensures transparency and also encourage accountability. That is a factor which was missing for many years for a variety of reasons. I am not trying to get into politics because this is nothing to do with politics also. This is an issue where we are trying to plug the leakages, shortages, shortcomings if any, and trying to improve the system so that the system can help the people. Jones Lang's Rasayan India, one of the industry, a real estate consultancy firm, opined that the enactment of the bill as a law will almost single-handedly revamp the way of the real estate sector works across the board, from developers, end users and investors to lending institutions and government agencies involved in the buying and selling of the property. Oberoi Realty, Mumbai-based real estate company, bill is an excellent step. On the significant issues flagged by the developers related to cost of the funds increasing on account of requirement to deposit 70% of the collection in a separate bank account. I must clarify, the account to be maintained by the promoter is a separate account, not an escrow account. Also, the deposit of 70% for both construction cost and land cost, this also has to be notified. Earlier it was 50%. Even the Senate committee recommended 50%. Some members have given dissent. I have taken note of the dissent also and I have raised it from 50% to 70% subsequently. 70. Then the promoters can use the remaining 30% for the other expenses incurred for other business purposes also. Because after all, you need to give them little cushion. Otherwise, it's not easy to talk about an ideal situation. But you know, the promoter purchased some land, gives advance to some other land. Meanwhile, he will complete this project and go to other projects. So keeping that in mind, we have given that much cushion of 30% available for him and spending 70% because you are assured the project will be completed in time. Lot of the projects have taken time. Some of them, sir, Madam Speaker, earlier delegations have come and met every one of us. What happened in Noida, what happened in Gurgaon, in some other places by so-called big companies also, people are pained. They are organizing. They are coming to us, including some of the media friends also have been taken for a ride. Normally nobody touch media. But this one, some unscrupulous elements, they have also have taken on media and they also have been really taken for a ride. They are also crying. That's why there was positive reaction because they have experience also. The promoter, the 30% is to ensure that the project funds are not diverted and projects are completed on time. That's why 70% stipulation has been brought in. Then I can assure the industry that with the establishment of a regulatory mechanism, there would be greater flow of investment because your credibility is investing, both national and foreign, to the sector, resulting in reduction in cost of borrowing. They should understand the industry who are saying that they are concerned. I can tell them, because of this regulation, the credibility of the sector is going to go up, the acceptability is going to go up, and a lot of more investments are going to come from foreign investors as well as investors from other sectors also. And then with that result, the cost of borrowing also is going down. Cost of borrowing also is going down because you have a lot of other avenues. Madam, the bill seeks to enhance the credibility of the real estate sector. As I said, right now, consumers end up paying more than what they were told at the time of launching of project. Subsequently, they will say, we launched the project, that was the rate. But subsequently, this has been added, that has been added and all. That is not allowed now. Secondly, that has to be put an end. Ongoing projects also, regarding the consequence of including the ongoing projects under the bill, I discussed the issue with my officials. This shall have a bearing on the projects and consumers. In fact, the Select Committee of Rajya Sabha, too, in its wisdom, supported and retained the need for regulating existing projects. But at the same time, projects which have been almost at the fag end of the completion and all, what they require is they need to give only information. We are not going to harass them because there is so much concern among the industry circle what will happen to the ongoing projects. Ongoing projects, whatever agreement you have entered earlier, the agreement stands. You have to fulfill the obligation which you yourself have agreed upon through an agreement, and whatever conditions that were stipulated in your agreement, they have to be implemented in toto. And all what I am proposing will apply for the future projects. along with the projects which got struck now. If necessary for me to clarify, upon passage of the bill, ongoing projects would not come to a standstill. Let me make it very clear to the principals of parliament. They will not come to a standstill, they will continue. The bill does not provide that the existing project should stop all operations until complied with the provisions of the bill. The bill do not say that. The bill only provides upon the formation of the regulatory authorities, all promoters of existing projects coming within the ambit of the bill would need to register and provide and upload all project details on the website of the authority. This is mandatory. A window of 3 months from the date of the commencement of the said clauses, sections have been given to the promoters for registration also. Reasonable time has been given. All the developers need to do is to specify the project details of such apartments so that prospective buyers will make informed choice. Project status is known to all and ensure that the projects are completed on time. That's the need of the hour. Regarding the provision of imprisonment for any violation of the orders of the regulatory authority, some concern is expressed in certain quarters, including some sections of the media. It is certainly not a first option, but only the last option. Let me make it very clear. You will be cautioned. You will be penalized. And if you don't adhere to the appellate the regulatory authority's order, then you will be taken to task. Why should anybody worry? If you are not violating any of the orders of the regulatory authority, nobody is going to touch you. And some people are saying because of this regulatory authority, it will be in one state headquarters or at some place. Do you expect every house buyer in a town to go to the regulatory authority? No. Regulatory authority will be there simultaneously. 600 plus consumer courts also will be functioning. Their jurisdiction is not touched. We have the consumer affairs minister here. The consumer courts also will have its own jurisdiction with regard to the cases wherein some people have a grievance. There are many regulatory laws in the country with imprisonment provision under 3 to 10 years of imprisonment is provided. Under the Securities Act, under the Insurance Act, under the Pension Fund Act, 10 years of imprisonment is provided. Food Security Act has 7 years of imprisonment, 5 years under the Electricity Act and Reserve Bank of India Act also. It is not that I brought in that provision only to deter these people. I am just reminding them there is a provision like this. Please be careful. That is the purpose of putting that in this bill. So, and that also, there is a, it is compoundable also. So the builder can exercise these options also at that time if something goes wrong. But at the same time, the authority will decide what to do. There cannot be a consumer without a developer and vice versa. They cannot be a consumer without a developer. They cannot be a developer without a consumer. So they have to work in unison and we have to protect the interest of both. It is important for the developers to mobilize land. Land is a big issue. Madam, I want to take a little time on this because my housing project, Housing for All, and then affordable housing, then weaker section housing, then the low income group housing, all are even institute development also. All these things hinges on the issue of land. Either the center or the states, at the earliest, they have to take a view on the land acquisition. The land is acquired for affordable housing, for the poor man's housing, for the common man's housing. Nobody should create any hurdles with regard to land acquisition. Or if somebody can give me an idea that houses can be constructed without land, I'll be glad to receive that idea and also ready to study that wonderful idea if anyone can make such idea also. Because earlier governments also have been constructing houses on land only, to my knowledge. And now also, this government also want to construct the houses in land. And if I go to construct house in the sea, like some other countries, my friend Mr. Prakash Javadekar will come into picture and then you say that you are touching the issue of environment and there are great people also here in this country without knowing the ground reality who will be shouting from the rooftops about this, that and all. See, the development, welfare and environment must go together. Some of the countries, they are developed, ma'am. I want to make it very clear. And they are trying to put so many regulations and then trying to teach us lessons. India is on the verge of becoming a developed country, fully developed country. We cannot afford. At the same time, we cannot ignore the nature. So nature culture and future, they should go together. This is what the government of India is doing. I'm, huh? It's a good combination. Naturally, my friends from Kerala are more concerned about nature, because it's God's own country and a beautiful place to see. If people visit Kerala, and we really enjoy, everyone in India, I feel once in a time, they must go to Kerala. They may meet Venugopal or may not meet, that's a different matter. I have no problem. But because Kerala do not belong to one person. Kerala is a beautiful country. There also, it's a state means country. Country means in that connotation. Can I use?
Please.
When you word use the Rajya kahte hai na Hindi mein. Rajya. If you say Rajya, Telangana is alag Rajya, Andhra Pradesh is alag Rajya. In language mein thoda aisa hota hai. When the description of God's own country was given, that is creation. That was the idea. So I must tell Kargeji and other friends also that even friends from Kerala, the people who are in the government, they are also concerned about the land bill. They want some solution at the earliest, because land is a major issue in Kerala also, and lot of activities going on. I am giving something, state chief is trying to mobilize something, and together they want to go in a big way for the housing sector in Kerala also. Keeping that in mind, I would urge upon all the people concerned of different shades of public opinion, different shades of political spectrum, please at the earliest try to come to some sort of understanding about the land bill, so that land is made available for the housing sector, so that we can really reach that goal of housing for all by 2020. Then as I told you earlier, I was referring about the option of imprisonment. It is the lowest than compared to all other regulators as far as the housing sector is concerned. That too, willful violation, willful defaulter. Nowadays the word has become very popular. Willful defaulter, or as said by, I think, Tathagata, who said it, skillful defaulter. Skillful. But defaulter is a defaulter. Some people have the skills and some people do not have the skills. So I appeal to the sector to understand the provision in that perspective. The government is aware that 40 approvals are required for housing projects, and the importance given to them, importance is that they should give their approvals in time. This is an issue agitating the minds of all the people. For house construction of a project in Kerala or in Thiruvananthapuram or Ananthapuram of Andhra Pradesh or some other Midnapur in West Bengal, people have to come to Delhi for approval for some projects. So projects are getting delayed. So the friends from the real estate sector, from Kradai, they are all raising the issue. Sir, you are putting all these regulations, fine, we have no problem. But at the same time, what about those approvals? Approvals are taking 6 months time, 1 year time, 2 years, 3 years also. The cost escalation takes up, and you are now trying to penalize. That's why through this house, during the discussion on this bill, I appeal to all the state governments to be proactive, and also urban local bodies also. When we insist on early completion, we must also see that the speedy approvals are given. For that, I am dealing with that separately. There are incentives and disincentives. Our government has come forward with the new regulations for the Amrut, for the smart cities, for the housing for all other urban development related issues. We are now telling them there will be incentives and also disincentives. You have to follow reforms. There is no way. You cannot perform without reform. And mere reform will not suffice without perform. So perform and reform, they should go together. So that includes speedy approvals, ease of doing business. You are seeing how the government of India is taking steps with regard to ease of doing business. Some people call it as a pro-business. We have no problem. Business also are, businessmen also are Indian. Industry also Indian. So they are also needed for the country's growth. As we always believe, agriculture and industry are like both eyes of a human being. So you need to protect their interest also. But at the same time, we have to see that the time prescribed is honored. So, madam, I'm happy to share with this house to streamline such approvals, because these real estate bodies, Kredai and the other one, Naredco, they met me. They met my officers. They expressed their problems, because this bill has come after consultation at various levels with various stakeholders. States have been consulted adequately. Real estate sector has been consulted adequately. And also media, whatever has appeared in the media, that has also been analyzed. And we had a stakeholders conference. My secretary took a meeting full day to hear the views of the consumers. Lot of consumers came, they poured out, and they also heard the NAREDCO today. They also raised certain issues. All of them have been analyzed. As part of that, ease of approvals, Madam, I am happy to inform the House, I held 7 high-level meetings with the Ministers of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, with the Minister of Consumer Affairs, my senior colleague, Sri Swamidas Paswanji, with the Minister of Civil Aviation, with the Minister of Defence and Minister of Culture. Any monument, if you have a monument in our town, to get permission for construction nearby a monument, it takes again time, because you have to come to Delhi. If you are constructing a project near the airport, that funnel, that area and all, then you have to come to Delhi. For one project, you have to come all the way to Delhi. And then if there are defense establishments are there, then also you have to come to Delhi for permissions and all. And then similarly, all these issues we discussed threadbare. I'm thankful to my colleagues, 7 of them, some of them are seniors, some of them are, Ramirazji, for example, is senior most that way. They all were very patient, they came along with the secretaries and they answered each and every issue raised by them, and all these ministries as a result have taken significant measures to ensure online and timely approval. I am very happy to announce in this House, many of them are now ready for online approval and also timely approval. Single window approval system, people talk it very easy, because in phraseology you can say single window, but it's not easy, you can't put everything in a window. But the meaning of the single window is easy approvals. Because our idea at the end of the day, the Prime Minister feels that man to man or woman to woman contact, that has to be reduced. Because you know, if both hands meet, what will transpire? I need not explain. I need not explain. It's a very... Sir, first of all, I have to explain so that you people can support me.
हम इस बिल को पास करना चाहते हैं लेकिन आप इतना लंबा खींच रहे हैं कि यू डोंट वांट टू रिप्लाई आफ्टर डिस्कशन
आई ओनली थिंक दैट आफ्टर आई प्रेजेंट दिस यू अप्लाई योर माइंड एंड देयर इज नो नीड फॉर रिप्लाई आल्सो आफ्टरवर्ड्स बिकॉज ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन इज सप्लाइड नाउ यस व्हाट इज नीडेड इज ओनली व्हाट इज आफ्टर द इंफॉर्मेशन व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज ओनली कन्फर्मेशन The Civil Aviation Ministry color-coded joining maps for 13 major airports available online. 13 airports are available online. 9 more by June 2016. Automated no objection certificate approval system and height clearance operational from 6th January 2016. So you need not come here. It is being supplied to all the municipalities across the country. You can see what is the height. There is a color coding also, you can understand where do you stand, and then you get approval automatically. If you file false information, then your project will be liable to be demolished tomorrow. That precaution we have taken, because simply self-declaration alone, you know how it is. The next, Minister of Culture, online NOC process notified, handheld APP heritage bylaws have been made. Defense, review of ammunition storage policy is also taking place. And area commanders have been given all the details. They have to share restricted zone details with the municipal bodies. They don't want to put it on the website, because defense security related issues are there. If you are nearby a particular defense establishment, that information is given to that local municipal body. You can access from the municipal body. The CCZMs for the 4 defense airports also will be ready by April 2016. Defense airports are there. They have a particular problem. Model building bylaws being finalized by Ministry of UD in consultation with the Minister of Environment and Forest. We are at the advanced stage. Any day, once the parliament is over, those bylaws will be amended and will be announced for the public also, so that the environmental concern, you need not come to Delhi for environmental clearance up to the project for a particular level. That power also, responsibility also is given to urban local bodies. I think it's a really historic step. Minister of Environment and Forest have agreed to integrate environmental conditions and norms in building approvals process and now including the model building bylaws by the Minister of Urban Development. Now it's up to the states to adopt this model building bylaws and there shall be no need to separate clearance by Minister of Environment and Forest up to 1.5 lakh square meters. If you are going to construct a project up to 1 lakh 5 square meters, you need not come to Delhi. You can get it approved there. That is one of the major steps taken by the Environment Ministry. I am very thankful to that minister because it will stop, because in the name of environment, lot of delays were taking place, and also what has happened also, there was some talk of environmental tax also. The revision of National Building Code, National Building Code 2015, finalized after incorporating Urban Development's model building bylaws, because the Consumer Affairs Ministry earlier, unless the building bylaws are modified and National Building Code is amended, you cannot. So you have to take care of these aspects also. That also, the revision of the National Building Code is finalized after taking our suggestions. I am happy to inform this August House that I will be announcing the model building bylaws, incorporating all these streamlined procedures in a short time. Ultimately, our target is to ensure that all required approvals are given in about a month's time. That is my wish. I would like to see that becomes a reality if the urban local bodies and if the state governments take a proactive role. I have an example from the Kerala area for the buildings and all. Each municipality has to approve, even for central government sponsored projects also. So the Kerala government, in a historic move, have brought in the legislation wherein they said if the project is approved by an authorized architect, there is no need for the municipal body to give permission for that. So such things, they should really help the hastening the process of the approval and also completion of the projects on time. To ensure housing for all, the government has launched the Prime Minister's Awas Yojana with the intention of constructing 2 crore houses for urban poor. So with the recent announcements made by my colleagues, Arun Jetri, in the budget, the concessions he has announced, whether it is the service tax, whether it is income tax, whether it is the FDI, in all this, he has announced a lot of concessions, keeping in view my request to give housing and infrastructure status. Without giving the infrastructure status, he has practically agreed upon all the suggestions I have given. I will be further working with him. I would like to see a day wherein the interest rates are further brought down. The interest rate to be brought down, the only way is the economy should go up. If the economy has to go up, we must all have bills like GST and other manner in which our economy can be taken to further heights. If you take the economy to heights, you can bring the interest down. That is the only way. I have some experience in Atal Bihari Vajpayee government where the housing interests were brought down to 7%, 7.5%. Subsequently, they have gone up to 11%. Now they have come back to 9.5% or so. But ordinary people cannot afford. For that also, Honorable Finance Minister has yesterday announced some interest subvention also. Interest subvention also, he has made a provision of, I think I vaguely remember, around 15,000 crores, he has mentioned yesterday also. So that is also going to go a long way. But I will be happy when the interest rate comes down to 7 to 7.5%. That will make home buyers very happy so that they will afford to buy a house and then will be able to repay it in installments. What I am trying to suggest to the House is that we have almost incorporated majority of the suggestions of the Standing Committee, suggestions of the Senate Committee, and also suggestions given informally by various people. Keeping that in mind, I would urge upon this August House, please understand and appreciate the intent and objectives of this important bill and extend full support. This is what I want to appeal to the House. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sri K.